how to get started with database projects in Azure Data Studio with Warwick this week on Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by Warwick, a member of the SQL community. Warwick, thanks so much for joining us again on Data Exposed.
Thanks for having me back, Hannah.
Always a pleasure. And today we're going to be talking about connecting the dots for Azure Data Studio with database projects. And this is something I don't know a ton about, so I'm really looking forward to just sitting back and watching you put all of the pieces together.
No problems. So what we'll have a look at today, Anna, is as most of our viewers would know, that database code's been around for quite some time. Database projects has been around for quite some time as well, and source control. But combining those three things together hasn't always been the simplest and easiest thing to achieve, especially inside of a single application or tool that's free. And so connecting the dots in Azure Data Studio with database projects and source control is an intro for our viewers who are wanting to start their journey on using database code with database projects and source control all inside of Azure Data Studio.
Awesome. It seems like a lot to piece together. Is it going to be really complicated?
Not at all, Anna. And that's why we want to take this intro to start from the bottom so that people can piece it all together, follow along with this quick intro so that they can start their journey.
Awesome. Let's do it.
Okay. So let's have a look at what do we need to start this journey? Well, first off, as we can see here, we need Azure Data Studio. With them having our source control, we need to have Git. So we need to create our local repository as well as our remote repository so that we can collaborate with our colleagues. And with that, we're going to use either Azure DevOps or GitHub. And finally, we need to have, of course, SQL Server, whether that be the box product or whether that be a cloud version in whatever form that takes. So let's have a look at the tools that we need to be able to get started on this journey. Well, first off, we come to the download page for Azure Data Studio. If we scroll down just a little bit, you can see that based on the operating system or platform that you're working on, choose which version of Azure Data Studio you want. For me, I'm working in Windows, so that makes it nice and simple. So that I can have my local repository, I can come to the Git for Windows download to get what I need to be able to get started. Because Azure Data Studio works on both Windows, Mac OS, or Linux, we can look at the local repositories exactly the same here. So we can download Git for Mac OS by coming to the Mac OS download page, or we can do exactly the same for our Linux and Unix environments. For our remote repositories, like we saw, we want to have a look at Azure DevOps. Now, I've already got an empty repo pre-created so that we can look at combining this into our environment, so that we can see that there's virtually no difference whether we're using Azure DevOps or whether we're using GitHub. I've got a repo in GitHub as well. So now that we've got those things set up and we've installed Git locally, when we do, the first thing that we need to make sure that we do is determine where we want that local repository created. Once we've got that and we start Azure DevOps, if we jump in and see this, for those of you who haven't already used it, there's lots of demos available on taking you through how to use this tool. But from our source control point of view, so that we can link our local repository to our remote repository and utilize those inside of Azure Data Studio, it's nice and simple. We come to the source control tab and we go clone repository. If we duck out to our Azure DevOps, we'll be able to clone the URL or our repository, come back to Azure DevOps, come back to Azure Data Studio. It will ask us, where do we want that to be located? So we need to navigate to our local repository. So for me, I've got it on C, presentations, and Git repositories. Select that location. This will take a little bit of time, not too long, because it's a blank, empty repository. Once that completes, it will ask us if we want to open that folder. We're not going to open that folder because we're going to open up or clone a second repository, which is going to be our GitHub repository, to make sure that we have the same look and feel regardless of where we're connecting to. So if we copy that code, come back in here. Once again, it'll ask us to go to the local repository location. And we can see there's the import project that we literally just cloned. Same thing, it won't take long for that to complete. Once again, we won't open when this finishes, because what I want to show you is if we go open folder and we open that at the high level, we can see all of the repositories that we've got available to us. Now it will take us to that local repository, Git repositories, go. Now you will notice that this will cause a refresh of Azure Data Studio. That's because it's going away and setting up the workspace that source control will work in. We'll also use that same workspace when we're using our database projects. Now, it won't take long, and we can see that we're nearly ready if we just go back to our source control. And so we can see now that it's finally opened, we can see the three different repositories that I've got available to us. Now, a tip, if you're wanting to know whether you're hitting Azure DevOps or whether you're hitting GitHub, name your projects in those appropriately. So when you clone them, we can see that my create project is in GitHub, as opposed to my import project, it's in Azure DevOps. Because the ADS demo, which was already there, we can just see that it's called master, and they'll all be the same. Now that we've got our source control available to us, what we need to have in place so that we can utilize database projects is that we come down to our extensions. And that's the beauty of Azure Data Studio. Based on what you're wanting to do, you pick and choose the extensions you need. So for us, helps if I can type. We just search for project and we've got database projects. By clicking on that, it gives you the information that we need. As you can see, I've already got it installed. If you didn't, then you'll be able to just click here and install it, nice and simple. There's two other extensions that we do need to be able to start our journey. And if we look at the DAC pack, our SQL Server DAC pack, we need this extension because database projects uses DAC packs as the method of deploying our changes to our destinations. And the third one that we need is our SQL Server Schema Compare. This allows us to be able to compare what we've got in our project and what we're going to deploy that to make sure that we're deploying correctly into the correct environment. Now that we've got those in place, we're ready to start. So to do that, we come to our database projects, and you can see there's a couple of options available to us. One, we can open an existing project that we may already have created that's from VS Code or Visual Studio. Or we can create our own project, which means that we're creating it from scratch. Now, whether it's for a SQL database, on-premises or cloud, or an edge, you choose what you want to do. The thing that you need to take away from here is the location that you're going to store that project. Because if we click on open, this is going to make sure that you place it into your local repository. Therefore, whatever database code you created is into your source control, and you're able to push that and commit it to Azure DevOps or to GitHub so that your colleagues have access to that. Alternatively, we can also import or create a project directly from a database. Nice and simple, same sort of options, but we just connect to an existing database that we have on an instance, and we pull all of those details like we saw before with the create. We just choose the location for our local repo, job done. So with that quick fire introduction into database code, database projects, source control, all inside of Azure Data Studio, I hope this gives you enough information to start your journey working with database projects inside of Azure Data Studio. Thanks, Anna.
Yeah, definitely. Thanks so much, Warwick. This is awesome. What I loved about the demo and the whole workflow you took us through is there were a lot of pieces, but you took us through breaking them down. And actually, each piece was quite simple. It's just a matter of formatting, setting it up, and getting it all configured. And then you can kind of create and start using database projects. I also love how you highlighted the extensions and how extensions kind of make Azure Data Studio so much better and easier to use because we have all these different extensions that plug in. So thanks so much. This has been a really great episode. I learned a ton. If you have any final tips or tricks for people who are just getting started with either Azure Data Studio or database projects?
If you're going to start with database projects, try your first project doing an import. It'll show you what you get because all you're doing is connecting to an existing database that is full of code. Okay, and you're able to then import that in and you can start and have a look at what does it create so that you know how you can go about starting your next project starting from scratch.
Awesome. I love that tip. Great tip. Thanks again so much for coming on the show today, Warwick, and to our viewers. Thanks for tuning in. If you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like. Leave us a comment and let us know what you're doing with Azure Data Studio, Git, and database projects. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.